Hello, fifth graders. Happy Monday. It's the beginning of week four of school at home. I want you to know that this week things are going to look a tiny bit different in ELA East, but I think it's actually going to be way easier for all of us. Your work this week is going to be 100% online. Every day you will have a YouTube video to watch and a lesson to do along with it. The way that you'll get to the lesson is right here on your Google Classroom stream. You will click classwork. And then you will find today's date. So today is 4/6. You're going to open it up. And then this is going to be a worksheet that's sort of like a double entry journal that we'll do together. So the first thing I'd like you to do right now is pause the video and spend a few minutes answering this question on your worksheet. Write four or more sentences answering this question. If you had the magical power to suddenly be in a TV show, what show would you want to join and why? You're going to click in this box right here, and you're going to start writing your response to me. And don't forget to use tag. When you are finished with that, you may press play again on the video. All right, welcome back. We should be done the do now. And now we're going to move on over to vocabulary. The first thing we're going to do is review the correct answers from last week's clowning around on page 114. These are your correct answers for you. The first sentence, your answer is principal. Second answer is ensure, absurd, tart, nestled, and then realistic. At this point now, you are going to pause the video and you're going to do page 115 all. After you've done that, you can press play again and we'll be able to join together for our reading. All right, so if you're done your vocabulary now, you're going to go ahead and highlight this whole section. You're going to turn it green so that it's easy for me to see that you did it. And we're going to move on. We're going to use the YouTube video to read page 157 to page 162. And then we're going to complete the chapter 8 questions, which are all right here on this worksheet chart for you. This column's for me to write in, and this column is for you to write your answers in. So before we do that, let's go ahead and meet on page 157, and we're going to read until page 162. P.S. Have I said yet I miss you guys? I miss you guys. Great job to everyone who's getting shout outs from Miss LaRue for doing so much IXL. Give me a call if you're bored. All right, Jeannie and Grandpa just left the house for the first time, and it's midnight, and it's getting really intense. And Jeannie's starting to feel pretty special because Grandpa really trusts him a lot. Top of 157. Take me to the middle of the yard, was Grandpa's order, but Jeannie could hear the shake in his voice. Jeannie took as slowly as he could, Grandpa counting under his breath until they got to where Jeannie guessed was the middle of the yard. 17, Grandpop said, finally letting go of Jeannie's shoulders. He breathed deeply like he was trying to suck in all of the breeze, or maybe smell the night. What outside really smelled like. What was odd was that Samantha didn't bark. As a matter of fact, he didn't hear her chain move at all. Maybe she was sleeping too. Grandpop was turning his head every which way, listening to the bugs and the critters, who were so loud that it was no wonder Samantha didn't hear him and Grandpop. It's been a while, Grandpop said, like he was talking to the outside. As if outside was a person. He rocked his back and forth on his toes and then bent down to roll up his pant legs to the middle of his shins. I could never stand wet cuffs, he muttered. And there was that scar again, the smooth of it gleaming in the moonlight. Grandpa, I've been meaning to ask you, what happened to your ankle? I saw it earlier today. Grandpa began to march in place, just a few steps, as if to stretch his legs. Ah, little Detective Wood finds another clue, he said. Tell me something, you this nosy with everybody, or just old blind men? Jeannie didn't answer, because if he did, he would have had to say, everybody. He didn't know any other old blind men. Okay, Grandpop sighed. It has to do with why your grandma ain't my, let's just say, first choice for this expedition. Grandpop stopped marching. When I first went blind, I used to walk around here all the time. I just didn't want my life to change. I didn't want things to be different. He tilted his head way back, as if looking at the stars he could see that he couldn't see. Don't get me wrong, I didn't go far, just a few steps off the porch, a little to the left, a little to the right, nothing crazy. And most of the time, it was just me sitting on the porch, playing my harmonica while Mary would be out in the garden, shooing away the birds and whatnot. Jeannie thought that sounded kind of cool. Grandma out there picking peas and Grandpop sitting on the porch with his shades on, playing some kind of pea-picking soundtrack. One day, when we were out here, I stepped off the porch. I took six steps. Was it six? It might have been seven, to the left, when I heard it. The loud hiss, like all of the air being let out of a big tire. What was it? What was it? Grandpop snorted. It was a damn copperhead. That's what it was. A copperhead is a kind of snake, guys. And I was headed right at it. And by the time I realized it was a snake, it was too late. It bit me, clamped right down on my ankle, hurt like I don't know what. I fell down screaming, and Mary came running over. By the time she got there, at least the snake had let go. We rushed to the hospital, and they took care of it. But my skin had a weird reaction to the bite, and that's how it healed up, with that scar. A copperhead? Jeannie knew exactly what a copperhead was. It was part of an extensive Google search he had conducted. Can blank defeat a honey badger? It turned out no, copperheads couldn't beat honey badgers, but they can beat humans. Jeannie tried to imagine what it must have been like to not be able to see that thing that was biting you, to hear it coming, but not to be able to get away. Oh, man. I mean, it had to be more poisonous. Had it been something more poisonous, it could have took me out, Grandpop went on. I would have hated to leave your grandma like that. So that was it. Mary was all messed up by it, and so was I. I ain't been out here since. Now this was the perfect time to be quiet, to just let the story end there and move on. But Jeannie's brain started adding things up, running the story over and back. A few steps from the porch. They were 17 steps. Way more than a few. This was the same yard, a yard that had once had a copperhead, which meant there could be more copperheads. Despite the glowing moon, it was still dark enough for Jeannie to have a hard time seeing things in the grass, especially something moving as fast as a snake. Grandpa? Grandpa grunted. You think that there might be snakes out here now? Probably, Grandpa said with a shrug. But don't worry. This time of year, they usually sleep at night. That made Jeannie feel a little better, but he definitely kept his eyes aimed at the ground and listened hard for that hissing sound. All he could hear, though, was the peat and repeat, and a sniffle? Sniffling? Jeannie looked up. The moon shone on Grandpop like a spotlight, and he was slipping a finger behind his glasses and wiping his eyes. Was he crying? Why was he crying? Wasn't this what he wanted? What's wrong? Jeannie asked, panic rising. Nothing, Grandpop said, toughening his voice. Nothing, he repeated now, a little softer. But then he took his glasses off, used his thumb and pointer fingers to pinch the tears away. Tell me something, he said, putting the shades back on. Are there any stars out tonight? Jeannie looked towards the moon. No stars there. It was probably too bright. But in the opposite direction, there they were. Thousands, no, millions. Jeannie had never seen anything like it. Yep, Jeannie said, staring. A whole lot of them. Grandpa nodded and gave a small, sad smile. Jeannie watched him, wondering what thoughts Grandpa must have been thinking. What memories must have been swirling around in his head about being outside. Then Jeannie turned his eyes back to the stars and thought about how terrible it would be to never see them again. At this point in time, you're going to get your worksheet up in front of you. You're going to read question number one. Why do multiple paragraphs start with Jeannie, she, on page 148? And you're going to type your answer. On page 148, multiple paragraphs start with Jeannie, she, because, oh, I almost gave you guys the answer. You're going to answer all four of these questions. You're going to do a quick writing activity right here, four or more sentences. Just let me know how you're doing. And then what you're going to do is you're going to go back here and you guys are going to have the option to click turn in. Okay. When you're completely done with this, you're going to go ahead and you're going to turn it in. If you have any questions or if you need help finding something on the Google Classroom, please call me or send me a message. I will be giving you a grade every day for doing the work that day. So on Tuesday, I will grade Monday. You have to do Monday on Monday, okay? Tuesday on Tuesday. And I'm also going to be giving you a grade for if you do this last part, the exit ticket. If you email me or Jupiter message me to say I'm finished my work, I'll be able to give you points for that as well. Good luck, have a glorious day, and I look forward to talking to you all later.